Hello from Bulgaria. I'm Senior Assistant Professor Netko Tagarev, and today's topic is Education in Management of Cybersecurity. The content of the presentation will be with introductions, cybersecurity basics, cybersecurity measures, cybersecurity trends and tricks, policy management and incident response, and of course the conclusion of this paper. So, for an introduction, the main problem in education process or program is the complexity of the management of cybersecurity. There are a lot of topics, and the two main reasons for this are minimum requirement for information technology knowledge and a huge interconnection between all the studied topics in cybersecurity management. The object of this article is cybersecurity management, and the subject is the education process. The goal of this article is to present a model for program for cybersecurity management education. The scope is limited just to management of cybersecurity. And this is the big scheme that I made. My experience is over 12 years in teaching and more than 25 years in professional cybersecurity management. From the beginning, it was just information security, computer security, but after the network security, it became cybersecurity management. So, here are six main models that have to be implemented in the program. First is cybersecurity basic, where we have the basic parts of information security, computer security, IT security, network security, and so on. The second part is cybersecurity measures, the defense mechanisms of our cybersecurity system. The third part is, of course, the threats and risks of cybersecurity. The second part of these six topics, the fourth, fifth, and sixth, are connected to related personally to management. They include these national cybersecurity related issues like laws, standards, design-based threats, and so on. The cybersecurity management process, where are the economic and management aspects of cybersecurity, and of course incidents response, how to respond to the incidents connected to cyber. So for the first part, we can present security management as a process, and we can see here this interconnection between all the topics. Of course, so we can change the places, but here we start with the regular physical security, which is very important. I will speak about this later. Information security, which are connected to these security measures, and of course all of the threats, how they are connected to our topics that we are teaching about. Of course, the four main parts of cybersecurity basics, physical security, there are two main issues, the physical access to data storages, and of course we often forget about the life cycle of data storages. In most of the programs, physical security is related only to the defense of depth model. Information security, this means the information security provides the basics for terminology and protection of our data. It's related, of course, of CII, confidentiality, availability and integrity. And there are a lot of standards for information security, like ISO 27001, NIST Special Report Group 80, and European standards also. Computer security, that connects to prevention, detection, and response to the incidents. And of course, this is connected to network security, network threats, network security measures, and in this part, we can also include a threat evaluation to our system and risk analysis. Of course, we are continuing with policy management and incident response. Management of cybersecurity have these two big groups, manager, management of the process and organization of the personnel. About the management, there are three main approaches. This is a proactive related to asset evaluation, risk analysis, and implementing the security measures to our system. This proactive approach is pre-incident. Reactive, this means incident response. These are procedures and reports for mitigation of the consequences. And of course, we have this type of crisis management that implements the disaster recovery plan and disaster recovery system. We implement crisis management when everything is broke down and we have real serious issues. Policy management and incident response continuing with management of cybersecurity. This includes management of the process of building defense mechanisms and controlling the system and organization of personnel. This means the responses, the roles, the other things that are connected with this. And of course, the most important thing is the asset evaluation, which assets, digital assets in our organization, we have to protect. The digital assets differs from the company assets that have to be protected. Often the organization assets that we have to protect are finances and link with the wall and reputation. Policy management and incident response have this main issue, cybersecurity policy, which is probably the most important document in the organization. It provides the assets that have to be protected, the resources that we have to implement for protection of these assets, roles and responsibilities of the personnel. Of course, the procedures when incident occurs, change management of our devices, of our data holders, and incident response. This policy has to reproduce to rely on the law of the region, country, or on the regulations that apply to this law. The standards, if they are such, the policy, the national policy, of course, the procedures and associated documents that are connected to cybersecurity policy. And conclusions, education in cybersecurity is a complex process. It has a lot of disciplines that are interconnected. Even that the different objects are divided, there has to be made a clear connection between the topics. So, for example, we have pretty much the same defensive mechanisms for computer security, for network security that interconnects, that makes some topics very hard to teach. It's not of great importance from which model we will start the education process. We can start from where we want. It depends on the program and it depends on the law. Also, it depends on the national policy and national regulations. Cybersecurity management has to start with asset evaluation. This is the process of cybersecurity management in the organization. We have to see which assets have to be protected, which are the critical assets in our organization. Cybersecurity managers have to recognize the different elements in cybersecurity infrastructure, so they have to have some technical knowledge. So, for example, they have to recognize the server and segregate it from the terminal, for example, or they have to know what is firewall, what is infrastructure, and so on. In most of the cases, disaster recovery has more economic issues than the cybersecurity ones. Disaster recovery is a very expensive process. It connects to huge investments. So most of the organization don't apply it and they don't have this disaster recovery systems because of these economic issues. In most of the cases, we can't count the revenue from the implementation of cybersecurity measures, which is very wrong. For your attention, I'm open to questions. Please contact me to my email.